The first time I used a vacuum chamber was to simulate a rocket traveling to the edge of space. We had a two-stage rocket, and after the first stage was done burning, it would fall back down to Earth, and then the second stage would ignite. We had a barometric pressure sensor that knew the atmospheric pressures as we were going up. So we just needed to know the pressure of the corresponding altitude that we wanted the second motor to ignite at. So we needed to test this on the ground. So we built a vacuum chamber out of PVC pipe, and we used a vacuum pump to suck all the air out of the PVC chamber until the pressure inside was equal to the pressure at the altitude we wanted that motor to ignite at. And this test was successful. I wanted to make a vacuum chamber to test out some stuff for our high altitude balloon. And since we make videos, we wanted to be able to see what was happening. So instead of using PVC, we picked polycarbonate. It doesn't shatter like acrylic, however it did bow inwards at lower pressures, so we're gonna have to make some structures to put inside later. And if it was just me making this, I would have taken the polycarbonate tube and I probably would have put either wood end caps or PVC end caps on. Before meeting Tim, my go-to materials are pretty much wood, PVC, foam, paper mache stuff, and Legos. But Tim has a mill and a lathe, so now we get to work with metal. For those of you who don't know what a CNC mill is, it's like the opposite of a 3D printer. A 3D printer builds up layers until you have an object that looks like what you made in your computer-aided design software. And this is called additive manufacturing. With a CNC, you take a hunk of metal, in our case we took aluminum stock and cut it to size, and use a cutting tool to remove all the bits that you don't want until that looks like the object that you made in your computer-aided design software. They have a lot of properties in common though. The movement of the cutting tool is controlled by the computer, and in a 3D printer it uses slicing software that breaks down each layer so it knows where the print head will go. And a CNC uses traces to determine its tool path. And Tim installed stepper motors on his CNC so it moves the CNC bed left and right and forwards and backwards, and the bed is where the part is held. And then there is also a motor that moves the headstock up and down. Some 3D printers, the print head is the only thing that is moving, and others are more like our CNC, where the print head is responsible for some of the movement, and the print bed where the part is responsible for other directions of movement. And the printer and the CNC need to know their coordinate systems so they know where the print head or the cutting tool is and where it needs to go. This printer has a calibration routine that determines X, Y, and Z positions. For the CNC, we had to tell it our coordinate system. We had to make sure that the aluminum was nice and flat. So we put it on pieces called parallels to keep it level. We lowered the headstock down and we measured its position. For the other two axes, we used a dial indicator to make sure it was even. Then we milled the face of the aluminum end plate. We cut out a groove that was thicker than the tube because this is where the seal would go. The seal was used to make sure that no air was leaking out. We drilled out two holes. One was for the barb that attaches to the hose, and this was running to the vacuum pump. The other was for a pressure sensor, and this way we could read the pressure that was inside the chamber. Then we rounded the edges of the end plate. We flipped it over and milled out the second side. The second plate was going to be the base of our whole chamber, and it would need to rest on the ground. It didn't require any holes, and it only needed a groove for the seal and the tube. And to make this seal, we used clear all-purpose silicone as our base, and then we added food coloring. The blue blob was thrown into cornstarch and then worked by hand until it became moldable and not just a ball of glue. I did wear gloves for the first batch, but then I struggled to get the gooey mess off the gloves, so I made the mistake of not wearing them for the second batch, and my hands were blue for a few days. But then I rolled it out and pressed it into the groove of the end plate and shoved a tube on top of it to create the proper form and let it harden. And this mostly worked. There were a few attempts, and the hot outdoors is not the best conditions for this, and one of our seals actually broke during filming and we had to replace it quickly. Since I do a lot of STEM outreach, I had a bunch of Play-Doh lying around and we made an impromptu seal and kept shooting. And that's how I learned to use a CNC mill and make a vacuum chamber. And recently Tim also taught me how to use a lathe, which is not computer controlled. It was controlled by me, and that was pretty interesting. So we'll post that video at some point. And if you guys want to see more videos on machinings and making, you should check out Tom Zelikman's channel. He's one of our Patreon people, and he's been doing live streams sometimes on the weekends in his shop. So if you're working on stuff on the weekends and you want to chat with some other makers, you should hop on there. Thank you guys so much for building with us. Let us know if you have any projects you're working down in the comments, and we'll see you next time.